welcome back to your social class. I am your social teacher Aisha. Children, in previous class we completed with our agriculture, right? Our agriculture about food crops, about kharif crops and all we have read. So in this chapter we are going to start with our industries. India is an agriculture industry. Everyone knows India is an agricultural industries. Okay, thus India is an agricultural industries. India produces large amount of raw materials, right? You know, our 68% of our country is a rural. In our rural country, in a rural is nothing but as villages. Okay, in our rural country, we grow many types of crops. Okay, now this crops has to be done to the finished products to get exact amount about basic community about commodities. Right, now for example, I'll give an example for sugarcane. Now we make a tea, right? We will have a tea. Now in that tea we need to add sugar. You know very well sugar is processed from sugarcane, right? Now can we directly add sugarcane in the tea? No, right? We need that sugarcane to be converted into sugar. And who will help us in this conversion? Yes, industries will help us in this conversion. Another example I can give you, cotton. Now we will get a cotton from where? From the cotton plant. Now we are wearing cotton dresses. Are we directly taking that cotton and directly we are wearing it? No, right? That cotton will be weaved. After getting it weaved with the help of weaving machine, then it will be made as a cloth. Then the tailor will take our exact measurement and he will stitch the cloth. Then only we can wear. See, the process of from the raw materials to finished products, it is taking the steps to finish. From the raw materials to the finished products, there are certain steps. Now, who will do the steps? Yes, industries will follow these steps, right? Now, how are we going to start an industry? How are we going to finish the products from the raw materials to finished products? We are going to learn in this chapter our industries. So, first of all, what are the requirements of our industries? Now, if you want to start a new industry, if you want to put a firm, or if you want to establish a firm, okay, what are the requirements you need? First of all, you need raw materials, machines, land or place, electricity, water, manpower. You all need all this. Raw materials. Why raw materials? As you know, for example, I have given as a cotton as an example. What will happen this cotton? Now you will pluck the cotton from the plant and you will take into the weaving machine. Where are these weaving machine? It is there in the machines. These are all industries, machine, right? First of all, to start an industry, what you need? You need a raw material. So what you will do, you will take a cotton from a particular, or you will take a particular commodity which you want to make it as a finished product. If you want to take a jute, take the jute and you will finish it in the carpets, ropes, bags and all. If you want to, for example, tea. Now you want to prepare a tree, now you have a tree plantation and you want to finish into the tea leaves. So you will take the tea leaves, you will crush it into the, you will take it to the particular industry and then you will make it as a finished product, right? Same way, raw materials is required. If there are no raw materials, there is no basic, there is no A plan, there is no basic alphabet A also to start from the industries. Then we have machines. Okay, so now suppose you are starting with plan A. To curtail to the computer plan Z, you need step by step, right? So plan A is raw materials and plan Z will be transport. Okay, step A will be raw materials and step Z will be transport. Same way, if you don't have step A only, then how will you move down to step Z? Right, one by one step you have to be climbing up. So raw material is the step A, then you will be start moving to the step Z, till the step Z. Okay, so raw materials you understood. Then we need machines. Now same, that cotton you will take from the cotton plant, raw material is a cotton, yarn. Okay children, simple thing, raw material is a cotton. Now you need a machine for this cotton to be weaved. Now which machine is there? Weaving machine. Now this weaving machine is, now we need to set up a weaving machine. How will we set up? Yes, we need industries. This will come under industries, right? Now you took the raw material cotton. Now here is a machine, weaving machine will come under machines, right? To convert it into the cotton from the cotton cloth, we need weaving machine. So industry machine is being set up over there. Now we need land or place. Where should we keep these machines? We need machines somewhere, right? We can't keep take a machine or we can't keep on the road. We can't take weaving machine or can't keep at the home. So what we have to do? We have to find a particular land, particular place for that. So we need land or place to keep this weaving machine. Understood, children? Then, now this machine wants current, electricity. Without electricity, can this machine operate? No. Every industry, every machine needs electricity. Without electricity, machines will not at all operate. Now, to operate this machine, what a person should have, what an industry should have, or you can say what an entrepreneur should have, he should have machines, electricity in that particular place. Now he will take a shed. Okay, for example, he took a big land. Okay, then he constructed some sheds. Then he kept the machine over there. After keeping the machine over there, can he directly start putting the cotton and can he take the cotton cloth outside? No, right? For that he need electricity. So that particular machine or particular shed should have an electricity. Then water facility is also very important, right? Now cotton cloth, even weaving machine also, if you put, can he put directly put cotton for that and come the thread? No, right? Even water is also important for the to finish up raw materials, the finished product. Even we need the water. Okay, then we need manpower. Automatically the machine take the cotton from the plant and can automatically it will see from the cotton cloth? No, right? There should be some particular person there. If the particular person will take the cotton from the cotton plant and if started to make put it in the cotton in the machine, then only the cotton cloth will come out, right? So we need manpower and labors for that. So next step, we need finance. Obviously, to start a machine, to start this, to get raw materials, to get the machine, to get the land, space, electricity, water, manpower, to pay the laborers or employees their salary. Entrepreneur or the owner should have finance. Finance is nothing but as money. He need large amount of capital. Okay. This is a basic requirement to start an enterprise. First of all, he should pay for the farmer for the raw material. Whatever material he is getting for example, cotton. Whatever material he is getting, he has to pay for the farmer. Then to purchase machine, he has to go for that vendor who is selling the machine. He has to pay the money for that and then he has to get back the machine. Then he has to see the land. He has to take the, he has to rent the land or he has to acquire from the lease or he has to completely purchase the land. Right, for that also he needs the money. If he is, suppose in city A, he is going to purchase, he is going to set up the industry. He has to see a land in city A. Once he finalizes the land, yes, my business will work here. Many people are here around surrounding. I'll get easy labors also. Transport roads are there. Transportation also will be easy. So for that, you know, he has to see the land. And whoever the landowner is there, he has to speak to him and he has to acquire the land. Either he will rent the land, either he will lease the land, either he will completely purchase the land. For that also he needs the money. Then electricity. Obviously machines need electricity. Right. Now, to get up the electricity also he should have wires, he should have plugs, he should have switches, he should do wiring for all over the walls. Then he should try to directly connect to these machines. For that also automatically he can't do. He need manpower for that also. So he has to have the people also for the electricity purposes also. For that also he has to spend the money. For that also there will be a finance. Then water. Water facilities also need. He has to connect the water to the taps. He has to take the proper taps. Obviously if laborers are working them, even they need water supply also for them. If they want to go for washroom or if they want to bath something, and all, they need water, right? Water is also an important source in every industry or every firm where they are working. Manpower. For that also, you should pay. For pipes, for water connection, he should pay. Then for manpower, obviously, now you are putting an industry. Okay, you are setting up an industry, you are bringing raw materials. For the raw materials to convert into the finished product, you need a manpower, you need a laborers. If laborers are only not there, how would a product get finished from raw materials? So you need manpower, and these manpower needs salary. You have to provide salary for them. That will also come under finance. Okay, then last we have transportation. And children, an entrepreneur and an owner or a proprietor, where he will start set up his industry is where there is an easy transport facility. Okay, now he will finish the raw material into finished product. This finished product to be taken should be done by the transport only. What he will do if it is no nearby transport, no easy accessible transport, then all his finished product will go into toss. It will be completely waste. So what he will do, he will see a nearby location where transport is very easily done. For example, maybe it's a railways or maybe it's a roadways. Suppose now he has done, now this is all done. Raw materials, cotton is taken, weave, places also the electricity, water, manpower, everything is there. Now he acquired a cloth. He made a big cloth. He made a bundle of cloths. Now he has to put these cloths into the garments where they are going to stitch the cloths. For this cloth, can he carry on his shoulders and can he go? No, right? He needs a particular transport. He will take a huge lorry or truck, you can say. He will take a lorry and truck. He will put all his stuff in that truck. And that truck should be very, this truck, the road should be very easy, very manageable to take down. Okay, it should not be having any potholes or something, or the road should be very clear. Suppose if he is putting his setup in some villages, okay, and the roads are not smooth, no pakka roads and all, think how much the efficiency, how much the hard work done by the laborers. And if suppose something happened to the truck, or if it is not reached on proper time because of no proper transport, there is a complete loss to the proprietor, right? So he will make sure where he is setting up the industry, there would be a proper transport. Okay, there will be proper roadways. If not, there will be proper railways also. Okay, so here comes the transport. So till now, I have finished about the requirements of industries, children. So in this next chapter, I'm going to start with classification of industries. Okay, I want everyone to go through it. If any doubts, we'll definitely meet our interactive session. Bye-bye, children.